Dear colleagues, welcome to this course in targeting of the thalamic-subthalamic area for tremor. In this course, we'll focus on targeting. Other aspects of thalamic-subthalamic TBS is covered in a number of other lectures and courses. This course is based on the self-study lectures to the right, the red nucleus and the STN, which was also a part of the course regarding targeting of the subthalamic nucleus. Further, targeting the caudal zona inserta and combined targeting of the VIM and the caudal zona inserta. After completing the lectures, continue with the target practice. The terminology in this area can be quite confusing. So let us just agree that what we are discussing is the area between the red nucleus and the posterior part of the STN, here encircled in red. I will in this presentation use the terms PSA and caudal zona inserta interchangeably for the target, even though this is not entirely correct. If we start with the historical background, then of course the pallidum was the first target to be used for movement disorders. In 1954, Hustler introduced the thalamotomy, which due to its better effect of tremor soon became the target of choice. The introduction of the thalamotomy in the ventrolateral thalamus naturally led to an exploration of the underlying subthalamic area, with the development of various procedures, of which the most important was the subthalamotomy in the posterior subthalamic area. This was first introduced by Wertheimer in 1960. The subthalamic area was intensely discussed at a meeting of the Harvey Cushing Society in 1963, and thousands of patients were operated with subthalamotomy during the following years by Leitinen, Mundinger, Hodar, and others. When we read the literature from the lesion era, it is important to remember that what was called thalamotomies were often in reality subthalamotomies. The term thalamotomy was often used to encompass also subthalamotomies, and some groups combined the two targets. A number of comparative studies were made and demonstrated the subthalamotomy to be more effective than the thalamotomy. It was used for Parkinson's disease, essential tremor, and many other movement disorders. It was reported to be effective for tremor, rigidity, and according to some studies also for hypokinesia. And with few exceptions, only unilateral procedures were done. Then came the introduction of L-DOPA and the subsequent decline of stereotactic functional neurosurgery, which lasted until the reintroduction of the pallidotomy and the development of deep brain stimulation. DBS was first used in the VIM and later in the STN and GPI, while the PSA was more or less forgotten. However, what we call the target is not so important. The same name is not the same as the same target. Sometimes we use the same name for different targets, or different names for the same target. We do not always hit the target, we have four different contacts, and we use different stimulation parameters. And it has been demonstrated in several studies that the best effect of what we call VIM-DBS is often, or even most often, achieved below the thalamus in the PSA. Simply by introducing the electrode a few millimeter deeper, one will often, but not always, achieve a pretty good position within the target area in the PSA. I think that we are now seeing a renaissance for the caudal zona inserta, considering how many groups that started to use this target. There are also some published studies where I would especially like to mention the work of Velasco, stretching over several decades. Further, some interesting papers from the group in Bristol. I have myself implanted more than 170 patients in this target and found it to be more effective than the VIM. If we look at the area of interest, then the posterior subthalamic area is located between the red nucleus and the posterior tail of the STN. It is bounded anteriorly by the posterior border of the STN, inferiorly by the dorsal border of the substantia nigra, superiorly by the ventral thalamic nuclei, posterior medially by the anterolateral border of the red nucleus, posteriorly by the medial lemniscus, posterior laterally by the ventral nucleus, ventral caudal nucleus, and laterally by the posterior limb of the internal capsule. The principal component structures within the PSA are the zona incerta and the prelemniscal radiation. However, in reality, we are probably targeting a cerebellothalamic fiber bundle passing through this area. And it must be stressed that we are not within the STN here, and further that the term caudal zona incerta is used for the part of the zona incerta between the STN and the red nucleus. This is not the part of the zona incerta overlying the STN, where you sometimes get the best effect of what is called STN DBS. Here we see the red nucleus and the STN in the atlas of Schaltenbrand to the left, and the three-dimensional reconstruction based on the Morell atlas to the right. The zona incerta is straight over the STN, gliding down over it in a posterior medial direction. According to the Schaltenbrand atlas, we are targeting the caudal part of the zona incerta, while the target area in the Morell atlas correspond to the cerebellothalamic fascicle. Here we see the relationship of these structures to the ventrolateral thalamus and to the anterior and posterior commissures. The target area is known under many different names in the literature, such as the zona incerta, the subthalamic region, the posterior subthalamic area, the radiatio prelemniscalis, and several others. Some consider that there are more than one target within the PSA. However, my personal view is that the target area is so small that it is not meaningful to talk about several targets, even if some groups differ somewhat regarding which point they are targeting. So, what is the target? It has for a long time been known that we are in reality targeting a cerebellothalamic fiber bundle, which is here passing through a narrow funnel between the STN and the red nucleus, before dispersing into the above-lying VIM. There are two reasons why it might be better to target these fibers in the PSA instead of in the VIM. Firstly, the fibers are more concentrated in the PSA, while you will reach more of them with your field of stimulation. Secondly, the fibers are probably more accurately targeted in the PSA based on the very close STN and red nucleus than in the VIM based on the far away commissures. Then, where exactly is this target? The atlas target is in the literature normally placed at a laterality of 10 to 13 millimeters, 4.5 to 7.5 millimeters behind the mid-commissural point, and 2 to 4 millimeters below the ACPC plane. But we do, of course, not use atlas coordinates. We use visual anatomical targeting based on the STN and the red nucleus. Here we see the development of the red nucleus and the STN from 1 mm to 8 mm below the ACPC plane. Three lines of importance can be applied: the MCP line, the Bajani line, and the CPB line. The CPB line is placed through the center of the red nucleus on both sides, extending beyond the STN. Typically, this line will touch the tail of the STN, or at least be within 1 millimeter of it. I target the colosona inserta in 6 simple steps. First, I place the target according to the atlas coordinates. We then choose the depth where the red nucleus has its widest diameter, and this gives you the set coordinate. We then identify the CPB line passing through the center of the red nucleus, and the Y is placed at this line or slightly more posterior. We then identify the lateral border of the red nucleus and place the target at 1/3 or 1/2 of the distance from the posterior tip of the STN. We choose an entry point within 10 mm from the coronal suture at an angle as steep as possible. And finally, we look at the trajectory in relation to the STN above the target point and move the target more medially if the trajectory is encroaching on the STN. Now let us go through these steps in detail. So we start by placing the target according to atlas coordinates at a laterality of 12 mm, 7.5 mm behind the midcommissural point and 4 mm below the ACPC plane. We then identify the maximal diameter of the red nucleus, and this gives you the set coordinate of the target. In steps 3 and 4, we identify the Y and the X coordinates. This is done at the level of the maximal diameter of the red nucleus, that is the level of your set coordinate. Here you can now simply mark the target directly, somewhat posterior medial to the posterior tip of the STN. You can also use mental helplines. We then identify the center of the red nucleus and make the CPB line passing through these and at or in close vicinity of the tail of the STN. If the head is rotated, just rotate the CPB line. If the head is tilted, then make the CPB line separately for each side at a right angle to the intercommissural line. We then mark the medial border of the STN and the lateral border of the red nucleus, and we place the target at 1/3 to 1/2 of the distance from the medial border of the STN to the lateral border of the red nucleus. In some elderly patients, especially with Parkinson's disease, the STN can only be partly visualized on MRI due to low iron content. Typically, the STN appears to be shorter and to end more anterior due to loss of the most posterior part. The lateral border is often affected, as well as the most posterior part of the medial border. The anterior medial part of the medial border is typically intact, and this does not constitute a major problem when targeting the colosona inserta. The CPB line is passing through the center of the red nucleus. This line will typically pass at or in close vicinity of the posterior tail of the STN. A loss of the posterior tail of the STN does not affect the CPB line, because the CPB line is not a line passing through the center of the red nucleus and through the posterior tail of the STN. And since also the medial border of the STN is usually well preserved, more anterior, the colosona inserta can be targeted as described above. We then make a trajectory. We will typically choose an entry point within 10 mm from the coronal suture at an angle as steep as possible, and neither sulci or ventricles should of course be transected. It is now possible to combine a trajectory for the VIM and the colon inserta if you want to. This is feasible in about 9 patients out of 10. In 1 out of 10, it is not possible to get a good trajectory through both targets. I think that it is wise to ignore the atlas coordinates of the VIM in those patients, because the location of the cerebellothalamic fibers in the VIM are probably more accurately predicted by the closely related STN and red nucleus than by the very distant commissures. In the final step, we adapt the trajectory to the STN if necessary. We look at the trajectory in relation to the STN above the target point and move the target more medially if the trajectory is encroaching on the STN. And in the images above, we see the path of two electrodes in the zona inserta from 5 to 1 mm below the ACPC plane. Concerning misplaced electrodes, I'm very happy when my electrode is within the blue area here. If the electrode is within the green area, I will still expect a good result and I will not move the electrode. However, had I done the procedure awake and seen certain side effects, I might in rare cases have considered moving the electrode if it had been in the green area. A problem with the colon inserta is that the effects of intraoperative stimulation can be difficult to interpret if you are not used with this target. And this is discussed in detail in the lecture on intraoperative macrostimulation, target-specific consideration. This course contains a number of exercises. I suggest that you import operation plans for patients 1, 2, 3, 11, and 12 into your navigation system. Download also the corresponding case guides. Then, create target and trajectory for the colon zona inserta and the VIM bilaterally in all patients. Look at the relationship between these two targets. After each patient, when you have finished, compare these with the suggested targets and trajectories. And with this, I end this presentation, and I thank you for your attention.